The Backstage Pass 2014, we're at Liège-Bastogne-Liège, the finish of the classics, and one of the realest, hardest days of the year for me. It's a very, very taxing race today. We're excited. We've got a great group of guys here and to support Simon Gerrans. And I wanted to introduce one of the old favourites of the Backstage Pass. We haven't seen him for a while. The old mate there, Neil Stevens. Hey, Steve.
Hey, Whitey. How you going, mate? Yeah, bloody good to be back. It's great to be back here in Liège. Great to be back on the Backstage Pass. I mean, haven't been able to coincide with Dan. He's been on a bit of a holiday tour up in Belgium, and we've been down busy winning bike race down in the Basque Country. Anyway, we'll see what we can do today here in Liège, and yep, great to be back.
You introduced your fan club last year. What have they been doing with themselves over 12 months?
Normally he can make a nice Christmas song like,
hey, Lou, my genius.
What's this Andre's been up to in 12 months since we saw him last?
He's a cold
one. He's on the same diet like you. He also lost some weight, so, and yeah,
I'm keeping up with Georgia.
Yeah. He's also on the steak nuts and veggie diet, so he's going to lose some weight as well.
How much weight he lost?
I reckon half a kilogram.
What's the plan of attack today, mate? Brilliant question.
That's a rip, mate. No, the plan today is not to attack, actually. I've just got to try and stick in there for as long as I can with all the major favourites, and hopefully they'll dwindle the field down, and they've got to try and shake me before the finish. So if I'm still there at the finish and coming into the finish with the front guys, hopefully I'll be in with the shot.
And just last one, how do you respond to the criticism about your efforts on the podium last weekend with the beer?
Time and a place, mate. We'll throw a few beers down after tonight, I think.
Just always looking for our leader Simon today, and keep him out of the wind, out of trouble for as long as possible. When you get what you want. Alright guys, the gap's coming down quick now. It's 12 minutes now. 12 minutes the gap. So tired but you can't sleep. Stuck in reverse. When the tears come streaming down your face. Cause you lose so
down there.
It's not. It's
a long way to go, mate.
I've got 700 k.
It's a long and deep breath. Deep breath. So Alba and Cam, as long as someone's riding tempo here, which it looks to be, then we just sit tight, keeping an eye where Gero is in the bunch. Right at the bottom, isn't it? They're running, they're going to catch them at the bottom. And then just the race starts. Alright guys, just paying attention for these counters here. Just paying attention for these counter-attacks over the top. Way, boys, keep fighting.
There's gonna be 30, 40 guys get over this. This is madness.
Gero's back good again because winning's taking him up, huh? Look for Gero's coming up on your left hand side. Gero's coming up on your left hand side with Peter.
Slows.
Come on, wing dog.
There's Gero, this is perfect. We got over this, we're up to here. Got that as well. On the wheel.
Oh my god. Watch out, Simon! Go, Simon! Go! Come on, go!
Gero! Hey!
Yes!
Come on!
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
Come
yeah.
on!
Look, Dan, it's stuff of dreams. I mean, Liège-Bastogne-Liège, Milan Sanremo, it's one of the monuments. You know, you look at the stages that we've won in the Tour de France, you look at this race here, it's never been won by an Australian, let alone an Australian team, and to be at the start line is something special. And to win it, and the way the guys rode as a team, the way they really committed, the way they stuck to the plan, was probably one of the better sporting moments I've been involved in. And then the last couple of kilometres, when I was explaining to Whitey over the phone, because he was in the car and I was trying to explain what was happening, and I hope he understood, because I certainly didn't understand what I was saying. So it was quite special, and yeah, really proud of the whole team.
Well, that must be a pretty big buzz in the group at the moment, mate. How are you feeling?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I feel awesome. Like winning a big monument is always a big thing for us. And I think we did, as the whole team, a really good job today. And Gerrans finished it really great out, so we're all really bummed for this and really happy with the victory.
Oh yeah, this is the nicest classic there is, and yeah, if you can win it with the team, that's pretty special, you know. Like yeah, Gerrans did an awesome job today. Like now the whole spring season suddenly is like, it's like perfect now. So yeah, I think we're all happy now.
What are you gonna do to celebrate, mate?
Yeah, I think I'm just gonna open some beers tonight, and we have to do something, you know. Like you cannot let it go like nothing happened, you know. Like we have to celebrate this one. Maybe it never happens again. They already opened a few.
The emotion.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Nice day, hard day, but we won, so we are happy.
Just, I think everyone's hard work into this, from everyone, the whole team, the riders and the staff and everyone, put lots of effort into our dens, and hats off to Gerrans for taking the pressure and winning the race for us. But yeah, great team effort from everyone. We're all stoked, and to win one of the biggest and oldest monuments in cycling history, that's something special.
It's kind of hard to believe, but yeah, I think that's what we work for. That's what we train every day for. That's what we put in the big miles for. And then today's like today, when it all comes together. I mean, it's unbelievable. Fantastic.
You know, and what you guys did, the way you put it on the line, bloody, really proud of you, from the heart. Bloody great stuff.
Yeah. Cheers, boys. Congratulations to all.
Green edge! Mate, that's as good as it gets. Hardest one day race in the world to be able to step it up and get Gerrans over the line for the win is just unbelievable. You look at the history of this race, and to be the 100th edition, to win the 100th edition is pretty special. Yeah, it highlights the history of this race, and I think it's the oldest classic, and to now have a Green Edge rider's name on, it's just awesome. Really proud.
Oh, that was real special. Like Clarkie said, 100th edition, first Australian to win it, and yeah, rolling across the line and seeing Gerrans put his hands up was just unbelievable. And I don't think everyone will realise how big a moment it is for a couple of days, but it's huge.
Unreal. Fantastic.
Oh, mate, I don't know what to say. Dream come true. It's always said to win Liège, everything would have to go perfectly for me, and it did today. really the guys never lost faith. I was struggling a little bit there, about 30k to go, but they stuck by me, kept me up the front in all the right times in the perfect position, and I just buried it to stay in the front for the final, and followed the right guys and just had the sprint to finish the job off. So it's just a dream come true. I'll be pinching myself for a long time, I think.
Maybe it will be my
Can you believe that? Can you believe it?
Mate!
How about that one?
Pleasure to work with
you. Can you believe that?
Great stuff.
Yeah. Always said, best road race in the world. And then everyone said, oh, Milan Sanremo. I thought, well, you've won both.
Righto, runner, it's about an hour and a half after the wild celebrations of the car. How are you feeling now that things have settled down?
I'm really, really good, really happy. Got an injury, Dan. Got an injury. Bruised my hand.
from
clay. No, I'm just wrapped. I'm so happy for him, and just a dream come true, and an amazing race, amazing team. We're going to celebrate for days, I'm sure, and just incredible day. We'll never ever forget this day.
Another very, very special day for the ORICA-GreenEDGE organisation. It's got to be up there, Neil, with stage win, Tour de France, yellow jersey, Milan Sanremo. How can you separate them? But it's another box ticked for the organisation, and very, very proud moment for everyone involved.
Yeah, you know, the thing is, when we've been lucky enough that we've done some great things in this team, you know, winning Milan Sanremo, winning our very first Tour Down Under, the stage win in the Tour de France, or these stage wins in the Tour de France in the yellow jerseys was unbelievable. Every time we do something like that, I think, how can we get much bigger than this? And we've done it today. We've done it one Liège based on Liège. It was a very special moment. I don't know what that next one is from there, but we'll be fighting and we'll be keep on going for more things. But thanks
very
much for the
support. I'll tell you where it is, Neil. It'll be the first stage of the Giro d'Italia. We're taking the Maglia Rosa.
Okay, good on you. Thanks for your support, guys.